Good morning friends, welcome again to my channel. Today we are making two different sprouting dal or beans, you can call it any way, it's a lentil. We just soaked the chana for sprouting, but the next recipe I'm going to show you today is the green mung sprouting. So for those of you who cannot handle these high protein dal or lentils, this is a great way to consume because your body does need that protein, right? And you don't want to miss it and say you love that chana dal or you love that mung, but your tummy cannot handle it because of the IBS or your autoimmune disorder, whatever you're fighting, this is a great way to replace that with the sprouted lentils, right? So let's get started. It's very, very simple. I'm just going to show you what brand I use. This is the superior quality. I got it from the Indian stores, but you can get any green mung of your choice. This is a mung whole. Make sure you don't use a split mung, use a mung whole. And I'm just going to go ahead and show you how the process is done. It's a 4-day process, but this is the most healthiest you will ever get in terms of a lentil consumption. And let's get started. Okay, over here I have the green mung. They're all green mung, and I'm going to add 1 cup of green mung. You can add more if you have to sprout more dal, but I'm going to show you how to use with the 1 cup, and we're going to fill it up to the top until here, so that way it has a very good soaking zone. And here we go, I have soaked it up to the top, maybe 3/4 of it, and I don't know how many cups, probably 4 cups to 1 cup of the mung dal, and I'm going to soak it for 24 hours and I'll be back. Alright, this is day 2, and as you can see the foam on top, this is the sign of it getting into the soak mode. And now I'm going to go ahead and rinse it very thoroughly and dry it in a paper towel, so that way we can start sprouting it. I'll show you guys the best way to sprout green mung, right? Now that we have soaked it for 8 to 10 hours, so you can also soak it for like 6 hours, all we need to see is these matured mung beans. You know, it will become bigger in size, and that's your indication that it has been soaked well. So now I'm going to go ahead and drain it, and I'm going to put it in this colander, and I will show you the whole process. I'll be back. Okay, I also have this heavy rod. This is just to maintain the pressure for our sprout. So I'm just going to go ahead and wet this paper towel, and I will show you guys how we can do this whole process. Okay, here we are on the next day. Over here, I'm just gonna open this paper towel and show you guys how we have started sprouting. As you can see, those little tails, the white thing you see are the tails. And I'm just going to repeat the process for one more day, and I'm going to start putting it into my plate and start sprouting again. See you tomorrow. This is day 3, and as you can see, there are a lot of good tails. These tails are really big, getting bigger. I'm going to let it grow for one more day, and I'm going to show you what happens on day 4. And then we'll start making our sundal or add to the salad as well. Okay, we are here at day 4, and this is how it's supposed to be. We have long tails today. As you keep for more days, it gets longer and longer. And the longer the tail, the more nutrition it brings to the plate. So if you like this video, definitely like, share and subscribe. I'm coming back with more videos.